Hello everyone. I'm sure all of you have heard of the Statue of Liberty, which stands on the island at the entrance of New York Harbor. But do you know who was it designed by and where was it made? Well, in lesson 93 today, we shall learn a bit about the history of this most famous monument in the world. Ready? Okay.Let's start with the keywords and expressions. Noble, monument, statue, liberty, present, sculptor, actual, copper, support, framework,Transport, site, pedestal. 下面我们就直接进入课文欣赏动画了。为了让大家听课文的时候目的性更强，我给大家准备了下面四个问题。Who presented the Statue of Liberty to America and when?是谁把自由女神雕像赠送给美国？是在什么时候？ Who designed the statue and who constructed its metal framework? 谁设计了这尊雕像？谁又建造了它的金属框架？ Where was the site chosen for the statue? 雕像的选址在什么地方？ When was the statue officially presented?To the American people. 雕像是何时被正式赠送给美国人民的？
One of the most famous monuments in the world, the Statue of Liberty, was presented to the United States of America in the 19th century by the people of France. The great statue, which was designed by the sculptor,Auguste Bartholdi, took 10 years to complete. The actual figure was made of copper supported by a metal framework, which had been especially constructed by Eiffel. Before it could be transported to the United States, a site had to be found for it, and a pedestal.Had to be built. The site chosen was an island at the entrance of New York Harbor. By 1884, a statue which was 151 feet tall had been erected in Paris. The following year, it was taken to pieces and sent to America.By the end of October 1886, the statue had been put together again, and it was officially presented to the American people by Bartholdi. Ever since then, the great monument has been a symbol of liberty for the millions of people who have passed through New York Harbor to make their homes in America.
大家可能也已经注意到了。这篇课文因为涉及历史，风格比较庄重，不同于叙述一个幽默故事时候的戏谑和轻松。Now, back to the four questions we posed earlier. Are you now ready with your answers? 一起来看看。第一个问题 ,Who presented the Statue of Liberty to America and when? 答案是 ,The people of France,presented the Statue of Liberty to America in the 19th century. 时间是19世纪，人物是法国人民。第二个问题 ,Who designed the statue and who constructed its metal framework? 回答是 ,The statue was designed by a French sculptor, and the metal framework which supported the actual figureWas constructed by Eiffel. 雕像本身是由一位法国 sculptor 雕刻家设计的，而它的钢架 是由另外一位法国雕刻家 Eiffel 设计的。第三个问题 ,Where was the site chosen for the statue? 回答是 ,The site chosen was an island at the entrance of New York Harbor. 选址是位于纽约港入口的一个小岛。最后一个问题 ,When was the statue officially presented to the American people? 回答是 ,At the end of October,1886. Now, do you understand why the Statue of Liberty was referred to as a noble gift? Yes, because it was presented to one nation by another nation. Next time you go to New York, make sure that you salute the statue. 下一次去纽约，不要忘了向自由女神像行注目礼。好。一起来看看课文中的语言点。首先请看课文中的这句话 The great statue took 10 years to complete. 这句话的意思是这座雕像花了十年时间才完成。Take some time to do something 是一个很常用的句型。请多看几个例句。It can take 10 years for a new plane to be developed. 有时要花上十年时间才能研制出一种新型的飞机。It took her eyes only a few seconds to adjust to the darkness. 她的眼睛只用了几秒钟就适应了黑暗。You should take time to explain fully. 你应该花些时间完整地解释。下面请看第二个语言点。The actual figure was made of copper. Be made of 的意思是用什么制成。又比如 The houses were made of brick. 这些房屋由砖块制成。The statue was made of marble. 这尊雕像由大理石制成。下面请看课文中的第三个语言点。The following year, it was taken to pieces and sent to America. 请注意 ,take to pieces 的意思是把什么拆开。To pieces 不仅可以和 take 搭配，还可以同其他一些动词搭配，比如 smash, fall, 或者是 tear。请看相关的例句。The poster had been ripped to pieces. 广告牌被撕得粉碎。Halfway home, the body of the car literally fell to pieces. 在回家的半道上，车身完全的破碎了。He took to pieces and reassembled an entire engine. 他把一整台发动机先是拆开然后重新组装。现在我们来看第四个语言点。Ever since then, the great monument has been a symbol of liberty for the millions of people who have passed through New York Harbor to make their homes in America. Make their homes in, 这个词组的意思是在什么地方安家。再请看两个例句。Tramps have made their homes in warehouses on the riverbank. 流浪汉们以河岸上的仓库为家。Many young people have chosen to make their homes in that part of the city. 许多年轻人选择在城市的那个地区安家落户。好，有关课文中的语言点，我们就讲到这儿。本课自始至终几乎都是以被动语态的句式出现的，所以在下面的部分，我们再一次关注被动语态的用法。首先，让我们来挑出课文中几个有代表性的以被动语态的形式出现的句子。 The actual figure was made of copper, supported by a metal framework, which had been especially constructed by Eiffel. 雕像本身以铜制成，由一个金属框架来支撑，这个金属框架是 Eiffel 特别建造的。课文中还有这样一句话， Before it could be transported to the United States, a site had to be found for it, and a pedestal had to be built. 在雕像被运往美国之前，必须为它选择一个地址，还要建造一个支撑架。这句话中 could be transported, had to be found, 以及 had to be built 都是被动语态。再请看 ,By the end of October 1886, the statue had been put together again, and it was officially presented to the American people. 到1886年10月底,雕像再一次被组装完毕,正式赠送给美国人民。这句话中也是出现了两次被动语态。现在我们总结一下，除一般现在时以外，其他各种时态的被动语态。首先，一般过去时可以有它的被动语态，这个时候的构成是 was 或者 were 加上动词的过去分词。请看例句。
They were invited to the reception.
他们被邀请参加招待会。
The police was informed of the accident.
警察被告知了那起事件的发生。再来看看现在进行时的被动语态，由 is 或者 are 加上 being 再加动词过去分词构成。比如
,New oil wells are being dug in that part of China.
人们在中国的那一片地区正在挖掘新的油井。
New opportunities are being looked for.
人们正在寻找新的机会。现在来看看过去进行时的被动语态，由 was, were 加 being 再加动词过去分词构成。比如
,He told us that the case was being looked into.
他告诉我们正在对这个案件进行调查。
The boy was being fed by the nanny when the mother came home.
母亲回家的时候，保姆正在给孩子喂食。下面是一般将来时的被动语态，由 shall 或者 will 加 be 加动词过去分词构成。例如
The furniture that he ordered will be delivered to his home the day after tomorrow.
他订购的家具将于后天被送到他的住处。
We will be taken to the Great Hall tomorrow.
明天有人带我们去大会堂。下面是现在完成时的被动语态，由 has 或者 have加上 been 加动词过去分词构成。例如
An inspection team has been set up and a plan has been made.
成立了一个调查小组，起草一个草案。
She is delighted to find that the room has already been cleaned.
她很高兴地发现房间已经被打扫过了。好，上面就是对被动语态出现在各种不同时态下的一个简单的总结。这篇课文讲的是自由女神雕像，这尊雕像被称为 a noble gift, 崇高的礼物。有这样一个问题，大家不妨想一想。
Why do you think the French presented the statue to America?
法国人怎么会想起来送一尊自由女神雕像给美国人呢？
Of what value is such a gift between nations?
Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. See you next time.